Hello.
Fellow Daoists, if you've read a few Chinese cultivation novels like I have, you would know that there are usually special dimensions or realms that are very important to the cultivation world for various reasons. These realms usually have historical and archaeological value, aid in cooperation of the Dao and cultivation, and most commonly contain valuable resources for cultivators. It is for these reasons that these special realms are so important in most Chinese cultivation stories, and probably deserve a general video on their own. However, just as these realms are filled with opportunity, they are also usually filled with danger. And few other realms exemplify this than the one I'm going to discuss in this video, the place beyond the dam, the realm sea, from the novel Perfect World. So to get right into it, we should probably answer the question of what the realm sea is. Keep in mind that this will contain some minor spoilers for Perfect World, or major depending on how you read them. So if you're reading it or planning on reading it, you might want to stop here. For those of you who have read it or you're too curious to stop yourself, let's get started. Now, what exactly the Realm Sea is a little hard to explain. It's not the most mysterious realm in Perfect World for nothing, but it has been described many times in different ways in the novel. It's been described as being formed from a pile of ruined walls, an amalgamation of collapsed realms and great eras past. As the waves rise and fall on the realm sea, the remains of past eras, great civilizations and ruined worlds can be seen. There are also several creatures in the realm sea. However, they say these creatures have all been corroded by darkness and are now only full of hatred towards the living and have lost most of their sanity. And the few sane living beings that are there and mysterious entities that sail on ghost ships, settle on small islands, or are in the process of being drowned by the sea's waves. The realm sea is blocked off from the rest of the universe by a dam. It's not specified if this dam is some kind of natural phenomenon, or if someone in the distant past built it to protect the world from the horrors of the realm sea. It's also secretly connected to various domains in Perfect World, including the Immortal Domain, the Other Side, and the Void God Realm. The history of the relationship between the Realm Sea and the immortal cultivators of Perfect World begins with the discovery of footprints leading to the dam. No matter how hard the immortal kings and undying kings tried, they could never leave so much as a single footprint on the dam. And so, it was theorized that whoever or whatever left those footprints at the dam must be an entity beyond the level of the immortal and undying kings, the fabled Immortal Emperor. Due to this discovery, many immortals and immortal kings left the immortal domains in a rush towards the realm sea. After all, if an immortal emperor went there, then there must be something there worthwhile seeing, perhaps even the secret to breaking through their current realm and becoming an immortal emperor, gaining the power to single-handedly control the universe. The immortals assumed that by getting to the other end of the realm sea, they would discover the secrets to becoming an immortal emperor. Whether this is true or not, no one knows for sure, as crossing the realm sea proved to be an impossible task for most of the immortals and immortal kings. Many of them drowned in the realm sea, and even more became corrupted by darkness. It is rumored that the secrets behind darkness can be found at the other shore of the realm sea, as well as other secrets pertaining to the origins of worlds and races. All in all, the Realm Sea to me is one of the most interesting, if not the most interesting, alternate realm in all cultivation novels I've read so far. It's by far my personal favorite. So, if you want to know more about the Realm Sea and of course the various other alternate realms that exist in Perfect World, because it has a lot of them, I suggest you go read Perfect World yourself if you like cultivation novels. You would probably love it once you get past the admittedly wordy and slow beginning. If you like these contents, make sure to like, subscribe, and I'll be bringing you more cultivation related content. So till next time, fellow Daoists.